So today we will be counting in tens, forwards and backwards. We will first count in tens on the tens, so like 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, etc. and backwards. And then we will do it off the tens. For an example would be counting from 3, adding 10 more, 13, 10 more would be 23, and so on and so forth. And now I'm going to show you how I would use 10 dot strips to count in tens with a class. Count with me. 10. That is 10 more than 10 is 20. 10 more than that is 30. 10 more than 30 is 40. 40 plus 10 will be 50. 50 plus 10 will be 60. 10 more than 60 is 70. 10 more than 70 is 80. 80 plus 10 will give us 90. And 10 more than 90 is 100. Again, we have 10 strips with 10 dots on each strip. So if we are looking at that one, that's exactly 10. If we're looking at these two, that's 10 more than 10, that gives us 20. 10 more than that is 30. 30 plus 10, 40. Plus 10, 50. Plus 10, 60. 10 more than 60, 70. Plus 10, 80. 10 more than that, 90. And 10 more than 90 is 100. As we see, 10 strips with 10 dots on each strip gives us 100 dots altogether. Now, if we were to count backwards, we would have to be taking away or reducing the result by 10 each time. So 10 less than 100 is 90. 10 less than 90 is 80. 10 less than that is 70. 10 less than 70 is 60. 10 less than 60 is 50. 10 less than 50 is 40. Take away 10, I'm left with 30. Take away another 10, I'm left with 20 dots. Take away another 10, I'm left with 10 dots. And take away that number of dots, I have no dots, which is equivalent to 0. And now, to work off the tens, we could start with 4. Somewhere in between 0 and 10 is where I would place my strip. Somewhere there. Okay. And if I were to add on 10, I would have 14 altogether. 4 and 10 gives me 14. If I add 10 more to that, then I have 24. 10 more than 24 will give me 34. 34 plus 10, 44. 44 plus 10, 54. 10 more than 54, 64. 10 more than 64 will be 74. 10 more than that, 84. Okay. 10 more than 84, 94. And 10 more than 94 is 100. just to annotate. Underneath that, we said we started out with 4 dots. 10 more than 4 is 14. 10 more than that is 24. 24 plus 10, 34. 34 plus 10, 44. So there are 44 there altogether. 10 more than that will be 54. 10 more than 54, 64. Add 10 to 64, you get 74. 74 plus 10, 84. 84 plus 10, 94. And 94 plus 10 will land us on 104. Altogether, 104 dots. So what does that tell us? What does this picture paint? It says to us, if I am sitting on 34 dots, if I have 34 dots and I add 10 more, I will now have 44 dots. And suppose I have 84 dots and I take away 10 dots, then I'm left with only 74 dots. And 74 dots, add 10 more, I've got 84. In that way. So eventually what you want your learners to be on top of following this kind of activity is for them to be able to identify the missing values in a set of numbers that are adding on 10. Okay? So something to this effect, something like this. If 4 is the first number in that pattern, adding on 10 would give us 14. After that, we'd get 24. Could leave this one blank. And write the one after that. Maybe leave out the last two as a way of working out if they've worked out what the pattern is. Again, it's not the unit that is important. You could have a 3, any other unit will do. But the idea is that we are counting in tens, and so the pattern must follow that. And with that, thank you very much.